Problem we shall solve under marginal costing method. Heading statement of cost and profit under marginal costing method. Statement of cost and profit under marginal costing method. First item is raw material consumed. This has been calculated. Opening stock of raw material at purchases of raw material less closing stock of raw material. So you will be getting prime cost, then you will be material consumed 455,000 per unit 45.5. Then you will be adding direct wages 230,000 and 23.00. Total is prime cost. Marginal costing is a method of costing in which only variable costs are included in cost of production. Fixed costs are not included in cost of production. Only variable cost. Material is a purely variable cost. Because when you produce 10,000 units and if the next year production is 18,000 units, then material will be a higher value. So material increases in the same proportion in which production increases. If the production is double, cost of material will also be twice. Because if the material is 10 rupees per unit, then for 1000 unit, the material cost will be 10,000. For 500 unit, 5,000, like that. Material is a cost of variable cost. Wages, they are also variable cost. Now factory overhead. There are some factory overhead, fixed factory overhead. There are some factory overhead, variable factory overhead. But only variable factory overhead will be taken into consideration. Fixed will not be considered. So now you will be adding variable factory overheads and variable factory overheads. In this numerical question, variable factory overheads are given 32,000. 32,000. Per unit, this is 3.20. This will be added. Total will be 7,17,000. Per unit, 71.70. When the variable factory overheads are added, the total is called gross marginal works cost. Gross marginal works cost. Marginal means variable. Only variable cost. This is gross variable works cost. Then you will be adding opening stock of work in progress and subtracting closing stock of work in progress. Add opening stock of work in progress. Add opening stock of work in progress. The value of opening stock of work in progress is 12,000. 12,000. Per unit, this is coming to 1.20. This will be added. You will be getting the total 7,29,000. And per unit, 72.90. Then we shall subtract the value of closing stock of work in progress. Less closing stock of work in progress. Less closing stock of work in progress. The value of closing stock of work in progress is 15,000. Per unit we shall be getting 1.50. Now this will be subtracted. So balance amount is 7,14,000. Per unit we are getting 71.40. So after you have calculated the gross marginal works cost, Then you have added opening stock of work in progress and you have subtracted the value of closing stock of work in progress. Now whatever amount you are getting, this is called marginal wash cost or marginal factory cost. Marginal means variable. So this will be called marginal wash cost. Or this can also be called marginal factory cost. Marginal wash cost or marginal factory cost. Now after the wash cost has been calculated, we normally add office and administration overhead. In office and administration overhead, there are some expenses, fixed office and administration overhead. There are some expenses, variable office and administration overhead. We shall be adding only variable office and administration overhead. So the next item is add variable office and administration overheads. Add variable office and administration. Variable office and administration overheads. Variable office and administration overheads are given 20,000. So you will be adding 20,000. Is it 20,000? Okay. Per unit is 2.00. Now we shall be getting the total. The total is 7,34,000. Per unit 73.00. Isko hum likhenge marginal cost of production. Now you have calculated marginal cost of production. Marginal cost of production. Within bracket we shall mention this is the marginal cost of production of 10,000 units produced during the year. This is marginal cost of production within bracket 10,000 units. 7,34,000, 73.40. Now you will be adding add opening stock of finished goods. Now we shall be adding opening stock of finished goods valued at marginal cost of production. Opening stock of finished goods is given in the question 800 units. Within bracket you will mention 800 units valued at the rate of rupees 73.40 per unit. Because this is marginal costing method and opening stock of finished goods, this will be valued on the basis of marginal cost of production per unit or variable cost of production per unit. The valuation will come to 58,720. 58,720 per unit. This is 73.40. Now we shall get the total. This is 792,720. Per unit will remain the same, 73.40. because 792,720, this is the value of 10,800 units. So if we divide by 10,800, we shall get 73.40. Now you will subtract less closing stock of finished goods. Less closing stock of finished goods. Valued at marginal cost of production. Valued at marginal cost of production. Closing stock of finished goods is given in the question 600 units. This is 600 units valued at the rate of rupees 73.40 per unit. Less closing stock of finished goods valued at marginal cost of production within bracket 600 units valued at the rate of rupees 73.40 per unit. The total value will come to 44,040 per unit. This will be same 73.40. Now the value will be subtracted. In rupees column, the amount will come 748,680. Is it correct?
Yes.
Per unit? 10,200 से divide करिए, देखिए कितना आता है. 748,600 divided by 10,200. You are getting कितना value आया था आ गया
73.40.
You are getting this is okay. Everything correct. 73.40. This will be called marginal cost of goods sold. Marginal cost of goods sold. This is 10,200 units. Marginal cost of goods sold 10,200 units. Now you will be adding selling and distribution overheads. Only variable will be added. So we shall be adding add variable selling and distribution. Selling and distribution overheads. This is given 10,000. 10,000. We shall calculate per unit. 10,000 divided by 10,200 units. Selling and distribution overhead, they are incurred for the unit which have been sold during the year. So per unit will be calculated by dividing the variable selling and distribution overhead by the number of units sold during the year. 10,000 upon 10,200. This we are getting 0.98. Now this will be added. Total is 7,58,680 per unit. 74.38. This total will be called marginal cost of sales. Marginal cost of sales. This can also be called variable cost of sales. Variable cost of sales. Within bracket 10,200 units. The total will be closed. We sell got two lines in rupees column and two lines in per unit column. Now you have calculated variable cost of sales. Or this is also called marginal cost of sales. Marginal means variable. Now statement will continue. We shall start with sale value. Selling price or sales. Selling price of sales. Within bracket 10,200 units. There have been 10,200 units sold during the year. The sale value is given in the question.
9 lakh
rupees. 9 lakh. Per unit this will come to 9 lakh divided by 10,200, 88.24.
Yes sir,
88.24. Now we shall be subtracting less variable cost of sales. Variable cost of sales. Variable cost of sales we have calculated 7,58,000. 780. 7,58,680. Per unit 74.38. So you have written selling price of sale less variable cost of sale. You will draw the line of total and in the particular column this will be contribution. In the marginal costing method, we calculate contribution. How the contribution is calculated? This is sales minus variable cost of sales. 1,41,380. 320. Okay. 1,41,320 per unit. 13.86. Less fixed costs. In the whole calculation, we never considered the fixed expenses. Now all the fixed expenses, they will be charged to contribution. So you will be writing fixed factory overheads. Fixed factory overheads. Fixed factory overheads. Inner column. This is 60,000. 60,000. Then in the next line, fixed office and administration overheads. Fixed office and administration. Fixed office and administration overheads. This we are getting 10,000. Then fixed selling and distribution overheads. This is again 10,000. In the outer column, this will be taken 80,000. 80,000. Per unit, this will come to 7.84. 80,000 divided by 10,200. 7.84. Now you will subtract this item. In the particular column, you will be writing profit. This is the profit. 6.012. This is due to a calculation. This you have got the profit. Then next statement you will prepare, you will put the heading profit reconciliation statement. Profit reconciliation statement. Within bracket you will mention reconciling the difference in profit as per absorption costing method and marginal costing method. Bracket closed. In the next line, as on 31st March 2021, you will have two columns like this. Under absorption costing method, you calculated the profit 59,920. This will be the starting point. You will put the heading profit as per absorption costing method. Profit as per absorption costing method. Then you will be adding at over valuation of opening stock under absorption costing method. Add over valuation of opening stock under absorption costing method. There is a difference between the value of opening stock under absorption costing method and marginal costing method. Under absorption costing method, you were having the value of opening stock of finished goods. वहां पे मेंशन कर दो हेड ओवर वेरिएशन ऑफ ओपनिंग स्टॉक ऑफ फिनिश्ड गुड्स बाकी स्टॉक में कोई डिफरेंस नहीं है ओवर वेरिएशन ऑफ ओपनिंग स्टॉक ऑफ फिनिश्ड गुड्स देयर ओपनिंग स्टॉक ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल इट इज हैविंग द सेम वैल्यू अंडर मार्जिनल कॉस्टिंग मेथड एंड ऑल्सो एब्जॉर्प्शन कॉस्टिंग मेथड There is opening stock of work in progress. This is having the same value under both the methods. But as far as opening stock of finished goods is concerned, this is overvalued under absorption costing method. Under absorption costing method, opening stock of finished goods has been valued at 64,320. Within bracket you will mention rupees 64,000. 320 within bracket rupees 64,320 minus marginal costing में देखेंगे 58,720 इन दोनों में कितना डिफरेंस है 5,600. If you compare the statements under marginal costing method and absorption costing method, you do not find any difference in any item. Only there is difference in the two items. One is opening stock of finished goods, other is closing stock of finished goods. There is overvaluation of opening stock of finished goods. You have written 50 cents in there. Now you will be adding this. $65,520. Okay. Now you will minus one item. Less overvaluation of क्लोजिंग स्टॉक में भी एब्जॉर्प्शन कॉस्टिंग में ओवर वैल्यूएशन है ओवर वैल्यूएशन ऑफ सॉरी क्लोजिंग स्टॉक ऑफ फिनिश्ड गुड्स लेस ओवर वैल्यूएशन ऑफ क्लोजिंग स्टॉक ऑफ फिनिश्ड गुड्स अंडर एब्जॉर्प्शन कॉस्टिंग मेथड of closing stock of finished goods under absorption costing method. Under absorption costing method, closing stock value is 48,240. Within bracket you will mention rupees 48,240 minus 4,200. Now you subtract this item.
61,320.
This is the profit under marginal costing system. You will mention profit as per marginal costing system. Marginal costing system. If they require you that you prepare profit reconciliation statement, then this will be prepared in this manner. And every time, because in case of absorption costing method, fixed and variable expenses both are included in cost of production. So naturally, whether this may be opening stock of finished goods or this may be closing stock of finished goods, they will be overvalued as compared to marginal costing method. Because in marginal costing method, we include only variable cost in cost of production. So, we have to put cost more in cost. So, opening stock, closing stock, value will be more. So, reconciliation statement, any question in any question, method will be made. Profit as per absorption costing method, you will be adding overvaluation of opening stock of finished goods under absorption costing method, and you will be subtracting overvaluation of closing stock of finished goods under absorption costing method. Then your whatever final value will be there, this should be equal to profit under marginal costing method. If this is reconciled, this means your all calculations are correct. But if there is a difference, profit does not reconcile, it means there is error somewhere in both the statements. So reconciliation statement can be prepared. And in practice, one should prepare every time. So that he may be certain in mind that calculations have been correctly done. Okay? Now I will put the heading, fixed costs. Characteristics of fixed costs. What are the characteristics of fixed costs? So, you will put the heading, characteristics of fixed costs. Number first. Fixed costs are the expenses. Fixed costs are the expenses which increase or decrease in total amount. Fixed costs are the expenses which increase or decrease in total amount with every increase or decrease in production. Fixed costs are the expenses which increase or decrease in total amount. They do not increase or decrease. Do not go. Fixed costs are the expenses which do not increase or decrease in total amount. With every increase or decrease in production. Fixed costs are the expenses which do not increase or decrease in total amount with every increase or decrease in production. अगर production दुगना हो जाएगा, fixed cost दुगनी नहीं होगी. अगर building का किराया अगर मान लो 80,000 रुपए महीने है, you will pay 80,000 per month. Whether you produce 50,000 units or you utilize the whole capacity, 1 lakh units. Rent will remain the same. Number second point. The examples of fixed costs are rent of factory building, comma, insurance premium of machines, insurance premium of machines, office salaries, etc. Office salaries भी जो आपने agreement किया है, एक साल तक salary वैसी रहेगी, फिर बढ़ेगी उसके बाद. Office salaries, etc. Vision 1 year, if the production increases, salary every month will remain the same amount. Then number third, fixed costs are the committed costs, COMMITTED, fixed costs are the committed costs, and there is a legal liability to pay the fixed costs. And there is a legal liability to pay the fixed costs. Fixed costs are the committed costs, and there is a legal liability to pay the fixed costs. Number third.
Number fourth.
fixed costs are period costs. Fixed costs are period costs. Comma. These are related to time. These are related to time. Comma. As 1 month is over, again and again rent is payable. As 1 month is over, again and again rent is payable. You will have to pay the rent of the building, and this is 80,000 per month. January is over, again pay 80,000. February is over, again pay 80,000. Every month you have to pay the rent. Next point. Fixed costs are more related with time. Fixed costs are more related with time. And these have no relationship with production. इस बात का टाइम से संबंध है, प्रोडक्शन से कोई रिलेशन नहीं है. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. सिंस फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट आर नॉट रिलेटेड विद प्रोडक्शन. सिंस फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट आर नॉट रिलेटेड विद प्रोडक्शन. Since fixed costs are not related with production, comma, fixed costs are not included in cost of production. Fixed costs are not included in cost of production under marginal costing method. Since fixed costs are not related with production, comma, fixed costs are not included in cost of production under marginal costing method. भाई फिश का ऐसा कोई संबंध ही नहीं है, तो आपको तो फिश का समीक्षा देना है. प्रोडक्शन के वो चाहे तो. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. फिश का आर पेबल इवन वेन देर इज नो प्रोडक्शन. फिश का आर पेबल इवन वेन देर इज नो प्रोडक्शन आर जीरो प्रोडक्शन. Fixed costs are payable even when there is no production or zero production. So fixed cost is payable even when there is no production. This means fixed costs have no relationship to production. This is the reason that fixed costs are not included in cost of production under marginal costing method. Next main heading you will put down. Characteristics of variable cost. Characteristics of variable costs. Characteristics of variable costs. You will underline this heading, then number first point. Variable costs are the expenses Variable costs are the expenses which increase or decrease in total amount. Variable costs are the expenses which increase or decrease in total amount with every Variable costs are the expenses which increase or decrease in total amount with every increase or decrease in production. With every increase or decrease in production. Variable costs are the expenses which increase or decrease in total amount with every increase or decrease in production in the same proportion. In the same proportion. In the same same proportion. In the same proportion, for example, if production is three times, variable costs will also be three times. If production is three times, variable cost will also be three times. Like material, 10 rupees per unit, 10,000 unit production, this will be 1 lakh rupees. 20,000 unit production, this will be 2 lakh. 3 times 30,000 unit production, this will be 3. In the same proportion, this will increase in total amount. Next point. Variable costs are directly related with production. Variable costs are directly related with production. Variable costs are directly related with production because there will be no variable costs if there is no production or zero production. There will be no variable costs if there is no production or zero production. Variable costs are directly related with production. Next point. Variable costs are also called product costs. Variable costs are also called product costs.
It is also called marginal cost.
It is called marginal cost. You have seen here. Marginal cost of sale are variable cost. Variable costs are also called product cost because these are the own costs of the product. Because these are the own costs, OWN. These are the own costs of the product. A product ki apni cost hai. Next point. The moment we think of production, the moment we think of production, we have to think of variable costs. The moment we think of production, we have to think of variable costs. Direct material, direct wages, direct expenses, power consumed, etc. Direct material, direct wages, direct expenses, power consumed, etc. जैसे आप निर्णय लेंगे, आपको कोई आइटम बनाना है, कोई प्रोडक्शन करना है, तो हवा में प्रोडक्शन तो हो नहीं जाएगा। आप मटेरियल लाइए उसके लिए, वर्कर लाइए उसको लगाइए काम पे। मान लो या तो पोडियम बनवाना है, हमने कहा पोडियम बनवाना है, वैसे थोड़ी बन जाए कहने से। यू परचेज द टिम्बर फॉर मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट, यू परचेज द नेल्स एक्सेट्रा विच विल बी यूज, देन यू हैव सम कारपेंटर हु विल प्रिपेयर द पोडियम और एनी चेयर और टेबल, यू पे हिम वेजेस। इफ दिस इज अ प्रोडक्शन बाय मशीन, then you think you have to see whether power is there or there is no power. So the moment you take any decision that production is to be done, it means you have to think of the variable cost. Because without material, labor, etc., no production can be done. Next point. Since variable costs are directly related with production, Since variable costs are directly related with production, and these are the own cost of the product, and these are the own cost of the product, and these are the own cost of the product, comma, since variable costs are directly related with production, and these are the own costs of the product, comma, variable costs are included in cost of production, under marginal costing method. Variable costs are included in cost of production under marginal costing method. Variable costs are included in cost of production under marginal costing method. So variable cost is directly related with production. These are the cost of the product, so they are included in cost of production under marginal cost of Fixed costs are not included because they have no relationship with production. Building kiraya pe le lo, baithe ho, tala dale ho, bhi kiraya dena padega. Niyam mukadma chala dega aapke upar. There is a legal liability to pay the fixed cost. Wo aapko dena padega. Ek question dekho. In a company, when 1 lakh units are produced, when 1 lakh units are produced, when 1 lakh units are produced, total cost of production is rupees 28 lakh. When 1 lakh units are produced, total cost of production is rupees 28 lakh. But when 150,000 units are produced, total cost of production is rupees 38 lakhs. When 1 lakh units are produced, total cost of production is rupees 28 lakh. But when 150,000 units are produced, total cost of production is rupees 38 lakh. Calculate the fixed cost of production and variable cost of production. So you are given a total cost of production at two level of production. 1 lakh units, 1 lakh 50,000 units. And you are to segregate the total cost into fixed cost and variable cost. There is a formula by which you can find out variable cost per unit of production. Formula is variable cost per unit of production equal to variable cost per unit of production equal to change in total cost divided by change in units of production. Change in total cost divided by change in units of production. Here this is 10 lakh change in total cost. 10 lakh divided by 50,000 units. This you are getting equal to rupees 20 per unit. This means variable cost per unit are rupees 20 per unit. Now in the next paragraph you will note down. For 1 lakh units, for 1 lakh units production, for 1 lakh units production, total variable cost will be, total variable cost will be at the rate of rupees 20 per unit, at the rate of rupees 20 per unit, for 1 lakh units production, total variable cost will be at the rate of rupees 20 per unit equal to rupees 20 lakh. And fixed cost will be rupees 28 lakh minus 20 lakh. 28 lakh total cost hai minus 20 lakh equal to rupees 8 lakh. Then next paragraph, for 1,50,000 units, for 1,50,000 units, total variable costs for 1,50,000 units, total variable costs at the rate of rupees 20 per unit will be at the rate of rupees 20 per unit will be rupees 30 lakhs, and fixed cost will be rupees 38 lakh minus rupees 30 lakh equal to rupees 8 lakh. This is another category of cost. This is called semi-variable cost. Semi-variable cost. If there is any item of expenditure which comprises of some portion as a fixed cost and some portion as a variable cost, then you will segregate and find out what are the fixed costs included in total cost and what are the variable costs. So if the information about total cost at two levels of production is known, then you will calculate difference in total cost divided by difference in production. So you will get variable cost per unit. Then you will calculate the fixed cost at both the levels. This should be the same. So there are semi-variable. And you are solving a question under marginal costing method or absorption costing method. You have been given information regarding various expenses incurred for 1 lakh units production, 1,50,000 units production. And you are to identify which items are fixed cost, which items are variable cost, which items are semi-variable cost. You will note down. Identification of, you will put the heading, identification of items of fixed costs, items of fixed costs, 100% fixed cost, as in items of 100% fixed costs, comma, 100% variable costs and semi-variable costs. Identifying items of 100% fixed cost, 100% variable cost and semi-variable cost. 100% और पूरी तरह से fixed है और 100% variable यानी पूरी तरह से variable है और partly fixed, partly variable वो semi-variable हो जाएगा and semi-variable cost. At two levels of production. दो लेवल आप प्रोडक्शन दिया है और आपको कास्ट दे दी है तो यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई. नंबर फर्स्ट पॉइंट अंडरलाइन दिस हेडिंग. कैसे पहचानेंगे? फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज if the total expenditure of any item of cost, for the two levels of production, मालूम पड़ा ये 1 lakh यूनिट और 1.5 lakh यूनिट का खर्चा दिया है. Two level of production. If the total expenditure for two levels of production is the same, this means the item of cost is 100% fixed cost. Item of cost is 100% fixed cost. 1 lakh यूनिट पे भी 50,000 रुपए दिया है और आपका जो है ये 1,50,000 यूनिट पे भी 50,000 दिया है. अब अगले साल प्रोडक्शन हो गया 1,60,000 यूनिट, यानी ये खर्चा 85,000 रहेगा. ये 100% फिक्स्ड है, चेंज हुआ नहीं, सेम अमाउंट. तो द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ एनी आइटम ऑफ कॉस्ट इज द सेम एट द टू लेवल्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. दिस मीन्स दिस इज द आइटम ऑफ 100 फिक्स्ड नेचर, 100% फिक्स्ड. नंबर सेकंड, अब आपने कोई खर्चा देखा वो टोटल अमाउंट तो बराबर नहीं आ रहा है, सेम नहीं है. अब पहचानो सेकंड पॉइंट, इफ द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ एनी आइटम ऑफ एक्सपेंडिचर, is not the same at the two levels of production. अगर total amount same हो जाए तो वो fixed cost हो गया. If the total amount of any expenditure is not the same at the two levels of production, comma, this means that if the total amount of any item of expenditure is not the same at the two levels of production. Hey? This means that to cut. इसी के आगे लिखो. This means that to cut. It's not the same at the two levels of production. But the per unit cost. Is the same at the two levels of production. अगर total amount same नहीं है तो आप उसका per unit निकालेंगे. But the per unit cost is the same at the two levels of production. जैसे आपने बोला material 20 लाख रुपए का लगेगा 1 lakh यूनिट पे और 30 लाख का लगेगा 1.5 lakh यूनिट पे, तो ये पर यूनिट तो बराबर नहीं है, वो टोटल अमाउंट तो बराबर नहीं है. आपने इसका पर यूनिट निकाला, पर यूनिट देखा, अरे तो 20 रुपए यहाँ भी आ रहा, 20 यहाँ भी आ रहा है, कमा लगा के लिखो. दिस मीन्स दैट This item of cost is 100% variable in nature. अब अब अगर 160,000 यूनिट बनाना है और मटेरियल का कॉस्ट निकालना है, आपने निकाला, ये तो हमारा जो है 20 रुपए पर यूनिट है, 1 लाख यूनिट पे भी, और 1.5 लाख पे भी 20 रुपए पर यूनिट है, इसका मतलब 160,000 पे भी 20 रुपए पर यूनिट रहेगा। तो नाउ यू सी द टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर एट द टू लेवल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, यू हैव कम टू नो टोटल अमाउंट इज नॉट द सेम। नाउ यू कैलकुलेट द पर यूनिट कॉस्ट, पर यूनिट कॉस्ट इज द सेम एट द टू लेवल्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन। दिस मीन्स दिस आइटम इज ऑफ 100% वेरिएबल इन नेचर। दिस विल बी कैलकुलेटेड for the next level of production on the basis of per unit. Third point, if the total amount of any item of expenditure, if the total amount of any item of expenditure, if the total amount of any item of expenditure is not the same, is not the same at two levels of production, if the total amount of any item of expenditure is not the same at the two levels of production, and per unit cost is also not same, agar per unit cost barabar aa jaye to ye variable cost ka item ho jayega, and per unit cost is also not same at the two levels of production. Per unit cost is also not same at the two levels of production. Mama, this means that the expenditure is an item of, this means that the expenditure is an item of semi-variable cost. This means that the expenditure is an item of semi-variable cost. We shall apply the formula. We shall apply the formula. Find out variable component per unit and then calculate fixed part and variable part. We shall apply the formula, find out variable component per unit and then calculate fixed cost, fixed part and variable part. फिर उसको दो हिस्से में बांट देंगे, fixed वाला fixed में चला जाएगा, variable So sometimes the information at two level of production is given. You can find out which item is 100% fixed in nature, which item is 100% variable in nature, and which item is partly fixed, partly variable. Clear? Now we will put the heading formula application. Important calc. Formula application under marginal costing system. Formula application under marginal costing system. Formula application under marginal costing system. For managerial decision making. Formula application under marginal costing system for managerial decision making. For managerial decision making. Volunteers, underline this heading. There are certain formula which are applied under marginal costing system for decision making by the management. Number one important calculation is, number one, total contribution. Total contribution. You will underline this heading. Then in the next line, equal to sales minus variable costs. Sales minus variable costs. Or fixed cost plus profit. How can you calculate the total contribution? This can be calculated. You have also seen in this statement. Sales minus variable cost or total or fixed cost plus profit. अगर फिक्स कॉस्ट में प्रॉफिट जोड़ दें तो भी कंट्रीब्यूशन में पहुंच जाएंगे और शेयर से वेरिएबल कॉस्ट माइनस करें तो भी कंट्रीब्यूशन आ जाएगा. नंबर सेकंड, कंट्रीब्यूशन पर यूनिट ओरेंडेस इन द नेक्स्ट लाइन इक्वल टू सेलिंग प्राइस पर यूनिट माइनस वेरिएबल कॉस्ट पर यूनिट. सेलिंग प्राइस पर यूनिट माइनस variable cost per unit or fixed cost per unit plus profit per unit. Contribution per unit can be calculated as selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit, or this can also be calculated as fixed cost per unit plus profit per unit. And there is third method also, or टोटल कंट्रीब्यूशन. अगर आपको टोटल कंट्रीब्यूशन मालूम है डिवाइडेड बाय रिस्पेक्टिव नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स. टोटल कंट्रीब्यूशन डिवाइडेड बाय रिस्पेक्टिव नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू आर गिवन टोटल कंट्रीब्यूशन 141320. दिस इज फॉर 10,200 यूनिट. टोटल कंट्रीब्यूशन डिवाइडेड बाय रिस्पेक्टिव नंबर ऑफ यूनिट, यू विल गेट द कंट्रीब्यूशन पर यूनिट. थर्ड कैलकुलेशन. Number 3, heading is contribution sales ratio. Contribution sales ratio. Contribution sales ratio, which is also called profit volume ratio. Which is also called profit volume ratio. आर पीवी रेशियो, प्रॉफिट वॉल्यूम रेशियो आर पीवी रेशियो. कंट्रीब्यूशन सेल का कितना परसेंट है दिस यू कैन कैलकुलेट. यू राइट डाउन द फॉर्मूला नेक्स्ट टाइम. इक्वल टू टोटल कंट्रीब्यूशन इंटू 100 डिवाइडेड बाय सेल्स. टोटल कंट्रीब्यूशन इंटू 100 डिवाइडेड बाय सेल्स. या इसी फॉर्मूले को दूसरी तरह लिख दे, आर सेल्स माइनस वेरिएबल कॉस्ट अपॉन सेल्स इंटू 100. आर सेल्स माइनस वेरिएबल कॉस्ट अपॉन सेल्स इंटू 100. या इसी को तीसरी तरह लिखे, आर फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट प्लस प्रॉफिट अपॉन सेल्स इंटू 100. आर फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट प्लस प्रॉफिट अपॉन सेल्स इंटू 100. So you can calculate percentage of contribution with sale. This is called profit volume ratio. If there are three products, you will calculate the profit volume ratio of the three products. Next line mein aap likhe, next paragraph mein. The higher the profit volume ratio, the higher the profit volume ratio, the more profitable the product will be. The higher the profit volume ratio, the more profitable the product will be. Because the product will be giving a higher contribution to the manufacturer. A higher contribution to the manufacturer after meeting its own costs. The product will be giving a higher contribution to the manufacturer after meeting its own costs. अगर पीवी रेशियो ज्यादा हो गया इसका मतलब है एक प्रोडक्ट में कंट्रीब्यूशन सेल रेशियो 30%, अगले में आगा 40%. 30% का मतलब वेरिएबल कास्ट 70% है और 40% वेरिएबल कास्ट कम है 60% है, तो उससे कंट्रीब्यूशन ज्यादा हो गया. द Variable costs are the own cost of the product. Now contribution, but the product is contributing to the manufacturer after meeting its own cost. Like sales minus variable cost. Variable cost product की अपनी cost है. उसको meet out करने के बाद जो contribute क्या कहा है, वो उसका contribution है. जैसे मान लीजिए दो भाई हैं, वो नौकरी करते हैं. एक दिल्ली में नौकरी करता है, एक बंगलौर में नौकरी कर रहा है, पैसा कमा रहा है. अब मैं पिताजी को 50,000 रुपये भेज देता महीने में, अगला जो है 30,000 भेज देता है. दिस इज देयर कंट्रीब्यूशन टूवर्ड द फैमिली. यानी वन सन इज कंट्रीब्यूटिंग 50,000 पर मंथ, अदर इज कंट्रीब्यूटिंग 30,000 पर मंथ. लाइक दैट ऐसे आप छह प्रोडक्ट बना रहे हैं, हर प्रोडक्ट क्या क्या कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहा है वो हो जाएगा. अगले पैगा में लिखो, कंट्रीब्यूशन इज फॉर टू पर्पजेस. कंट्रीब्यूशन जो होता है वो दो पर्पज के लिए है. कंट्रीब्यूशन इज फॉर टू पर्पजेस, फॉर मीटिंग द फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट्स, फॉर मीटिंग द फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट्स. कंट्रीब्यूशन इज फॉर टू पर्पजेस, फॉर मीटिंग द फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट एंड फॉर सेविंग सम अमाउंट एज प्रॉफिट. And for saving some amount as profit. Contribution is for meeting for two purposes, for meeting fixed costs and for saving some amount as profit. Fixed cost घटाएंगे तो profit बचेगा. तो contribution के दो purpose हैं. अब अगर आपके fixed cost ज्यादा हो गई तो आप नुकसान में आ जाएंगे, loss में आ जाएंगे. अगला formula लिखो. This you have written PV ratio. Next heading, no profit, no loss point. Our break even point. No profit, no loss point. Our break even point in units. No profit, no loss point. Our break even point in units. कितना यूनिट बेचे कि ना प्रॉफिट हो ना लॉस हो. इसे निकालने का फॉर्मूला है इक्वल टू फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट डिवाइडेड बाई कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन पर यूनिट. फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट को अगर हम कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन पर यूनिट से डिवाइड कर दें तो हमको नंबर ऑफ यूनिट मालूम हो जाएगा. कितना यूनिट बेचेंगे तो ना प्रॉफिट होगा ना लॉस होगा. Every manufacturer must have information, always he must have information, what is the break-even point of the business. If the actual sale is above the break-even point, it means you are running in profit. If the actual sale is equal to break-even point, it means you are neither earning any profit, neither incurring any loss. If the actual sale is less than break-even point, it means you are running in loss.
Thank you.